Hey guys, welcome to Electronics Innovation. Today we are going to see how heart beats, how it pumps blood to the whole human body, and what is AD8232 and how it works, and what is the theory behind of this Arduino cardiogram. So let's get started. The required components are Arduino development board, electrodes and electrode connecting wires, AD8232 sensor breakout board, bunch of connecting wires. Before going to interface AD8232 with the Arduino, let's see the theory behind of this cardiogram. The right side of the heart receives venous blood from the body through the superior and inferior vena cava, which enter the right atrium. Blood flows through the tricuspid valve into the right ventricle. Blood leaves the right ventricle through the pulmonary valve into the main pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery divided into the right and left pulmonary arteries to transport the deoxygenated blood from the right side of the heart to the right and left lungs. The pulmonary arteries branch further into the pulmonary capillary bed, where oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange occurs. The four pulmonary veins, two from the right lung and two from the left lung, carry oxygenated blood from the lungs to the left side of the heart. The oxygenated blood flows from the left atrium through the mitral valve and into the left ventricle, and out through the aortic valve and into the aorta and to the body. Electrical impulses originated in the syroatrial node located at the junction of right atrium and super vena cava. The electrical impulses generated from the SA node travels through the right and left atrium, causing the atria to contract. The impulse then travels to the atrial ventricular node, AV node, then to the bundle of His, and finally through the right and left bundle branches of the ventricles, causing the ventricles to contract. The P wave of electrocardiogram represents atrial contraction. The PR interval is the measure of time from the onset of the atrial contraction to the onset of the ventricle contraction. The QRS complex represents the complete depolarization of the ventricles. The ST segment represents the complete depolarization of the ventricles. The elevation or depression of the segment may be indicated heart muscle ischemia. The QT interval represents the complete depolarization and repolarization of the ventricles. The prolonged QT interval is a risk factor for ventricular arrhythmias and sudden death. So we have AD8232 heart monitor sensor, and in this sensor we have AD8232's chip. And this chip will process the all signal which we get from the body. Human body will give the lot of noise, and this chip will do some modification and reduce the all noise there and gives the output. So this chip will get the input from this jack, and this chip will deliver the output to this side. At the input side we have three pins like RA, LA and RL. And these three pins are internally connected with this jack. And at the output side we have around 6 pins, and out of 6 pins we will be using these 5 pins, that is ground, 3.3 volts, output and LO minus and LO positive. And here we have one LED which is in heart symbol. So this is all about this AD8232 sensor, and at the back side there is nothing, and we have some jumpers to interface. That's it. Here we have both electrodes and its connector. We need to make a connection between of them like this. Repeat the same process for all two. On the other hand, we have a 3.5 mm jack. We need to interface this audio jack with the AD8232 breakout board. It is having a 3.5 mm female jack. Interface like this. Here we have a 6 pins to interface with the Arduino. Connect the circuit as shown in the diagram. Let me quickly make the connections. I successfully made all the connections. Let me connect the Arduino data cable. Place all three electrodes as shown in the video. Open ecg.info file. Here we got the program open. Let me quickly explain the program. In the void setup, we have initialized serial.begin as 9600. That means we are using 9600 baud rate for serial communication. And pin mode 10, input and 11, input. We are using these pins for detection of L0 plus and L0 minus. Here we are checking whether L0 plus or L0 minus is giving 1. If it is not 1, then analog read of A0 will be plotted on the serial plotter. We are giving 1 millisecond delay. Let me upload sketch to the Arduino. Go to the board Arduino Uno and port is COM16. And I click on upload. It is getting upload. And upload has been done. Let me open serial plotter. Yeah. We are getting the wave. This is the cardiogram of my heart. My heart is beating like this. Now we will see the serial monitor readings. If we are observe here, we are getting a 3-digit values, and all these 3-digit values are plotted on the serial plotter. That is how we are getting the graph. So let me show this again. Yeah. Here we have seen how we can get the cardiogram using AD8232.